Right, so you are in a plain stone corridor. It appears to have been roughly worked. Nothing is very smooth. And the spiders must have gotten in, because looking above you, the entire roof is covered in cobwebs. You can barely see the stone behind it.
I'm going to cast Burning Hands on the cobwebs.
Alright, you do so. You see the roughly worked ceiling. Cobwebs burn fairly easily.
Okay.
Alright.
You can never... Is there anything in the ceiling?
Are you going to roll Surge?
Aside from
roll a Surge.
So does the ceiling look like it's going to collapse in any second now?
Someone roll to check it.
Mostly just the stone, but... Yes, roll a D percentile, those of you with thief levels.
Alright.
Okay, hold on.
Where's dice?
I'm going to use my real dice, and I promise, absolutely promise, I will not cheat.
Where are the different... Okay,
you have to add the macros. They only have the D20 for now.
I got a 6% or 6 on my percentile.
Wait,
6%.
Yep.
That's pretty friggin' awful.
55.
That's so.
Yeah.
No, actually, that's very good.
Oh yeah, that's right. Because you want to roll low and
you want to roll under the percentile number.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, my find remove traps is 65. So.
65.
Right, so what are you checking again?
For traps.
The ceiling?
Yeah.
The ceiling has no apparent traps.
Alright, now the floor. Right.
the door. 45.
45, that's still under 65.
Yep.
So, the floor reveals no traps. However, taking a good look at the door, you notice that the hinges are missing pins.
It's going to fall on us, isn't it? I poke the door with my 10-foot pole.
Would I?
The door is too heavy to just fall over from being poked like that.
We all poke the door with our 10-foot poles.
I hand the door... which of us is the strongest?
Not me.
Probably me and
Let's
Doctor.
See, I got a strength of 18 sass, 62 percentile.
Yeah, that's pretty strong.
I'll hand my 10-foot pole over to him and have him prod the door.
Oh, wait, I already got my own 10-foot pole.
Okay.
Roll a strength check.
I'm going to stand back while he does this.
I've got a 10-foot pole in my pants, if you know what I'm saying.
Okay. Yeah, move your guy closer.
Don't forget to actually move your pog to within 10 feet.
So around here, and...
that's 15.
How do I roll?
Yeah, everyone is 5 feet.
Wait, so how do I roll?
You need to add the dice macro first.
Yeah, you should have the d20 though, so...
To roll a strength check in first and probably second edition, you roll a d20 and you want to roll under your stat.
Yes, low is good.
First edition is so weird.
I'm used to rolling over and adding the modifier.
Wait, yeah. I'm used to I think, okay, 18 is a plus 4 to strength, but then I think, wait, I have a 16.
No, just roll under 18 on a d20. Roll under 18 on a d20. That's all you need to do.
Really? Okay, so how do I do that in a game table?
In the dice macros, you should have the d20 already there.
Dice macros, okay. So
you don't actually need the dice macros to roll. You can also just go slash roll
d20. Do I need to add modifiers or anything?
No, you rolled under 4, it's fine.
No.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Our world
first edition really doesn't believe in modifiers that much.
Okay. So
he prodded the door, did it fall over?
So
he did not prod the door, he smacked the hell out of that door. And it just went thump.
Thump.
Yes.
Did it thump. Sound like a solid thump or a hollow thump?
Well, let me put it this way. You can now see this room.
Ooh. Hang on. Let me check my spells again. What do we see in there? Do you see anything?
Well, nothing in particular. It's a corridor that seems to sort of taper off towards your left.
I'm gonna find remove traps, also move silently and hide.
Alright, keep rolling that D100.
Okay, first, find remove. Now, hide. Now move silently.
Okay.
Okay, I failed to move silently, but the other two I passed.
I'm gonna search for traps as well.
Wait, which one is cut?
Nope, I did not roll under my percentage. I rolled a 69. Very nice.
It's nice. It's very good.
I'm gonna cast Detect Invisibility. So I'm gonna move up and cast Detect Invisibility.
Okay.
How do spell rolls work?
What spell rolls?
You just cast it.
You just cast it? Oh, there's no rolls at all?
Yeah, you don't need to roll for casting.
You never need to roll for casting unless you were doing a ray attack, and you need to roll like a touch attack or something.
Alright, does the floor have any traps?
Wait, so which of these was fine traps?
The 12.
Ah.
And my hide was successful, but my move silently was not.
Ah. Well, in any case, you did notice a certain touch plate.
Oh!
That's a really big
touch plate.
Wow!
is it a pit trap, or is it just
yes.
a touch plate?
Okay. It's a pit trap that you activated by touching the touch plate.
Oh,
with,
so
with
like
your 10-foot pole.
With your 10-foot
pole. Oh, okay.
What's at the bottom?
You don't want to know what's on the bottom, okay?
Spikes?
You just don't want to know.
Okay.
Yes.
Are they gem encrusted?
In this case, no.
Oh.
I'm glad most of the people here actually got that.
They are 10 feet deep.
Okay. Any other traps in the floor?
I'm gonna check the walls for traps as we move along, slowly.
Yeah, I'll check the door once we get to the door.
I rolled a 25 for looking for traps in the walls.
I don't think I wouldn't want to touch the walls.
Two for in the door. Woo.
Alright. You have located no traps.
Alright.
Neither of us?
I'm gonna search for hidden doors. So that's a 1 in 6 chance.
Well, it's 2 in 6 if you're actually searching.
Right, yeah, 2 in 6 is...
It's 1 in 6 if you don't announce that.
Right.
I think I'll search for those, too.
I'll do that, too. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah, that sounds like a fantastic idea.
Yeah.
Nope. Because I got a 3.
I got a 5. No dice for me, either.
I got a 5,
I got a 2!
Oh, hey, nice. There you go.
Congratulations. You are fairly sure that there are no secret doors.
All right.
Okay. So is the door, and the door is not trapped, is it, right?
Yeah. Okay. So far as you can tell.
Is it locked?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to try and pick an open lock,
You're gonna try to pick the door?
Is that pick? Oh, open lock 72, okay. I'm gonna try and open it.
Don't actually open it yet, just open lock.
Wait.
Yeah, I did not unlock it, I got a 76.
Okay, I'll try to unlock it. 62, yes!
Sweet. Or,
but I don't open it yet. Now I'm going to listen at the thing. Listen at the door.
Do a listen check. See if there are any enemies behind the door.
Yeah. My hear noise is 35. Fail. Anyone else want to give it a shot?
No, what you hear is,
we're going to rape you.
Even if you fail, you hear that as well.
Wait, how does listening work in this? I don't know what my skills are.
You don't have any.
If you're not a thief, there are no skills.
Yeah.
Aww.
Where is my listening thing?
Terribly
it's
sorry.
Hear noise. It's like 13
noise.
Bottom.
Okay, yeah.
It should
35%.
Be the same. Yeah, the same number.
Nope, I got an 89.
Okay, does someone not squishy want to open the door?
I'll open the door.
I will step back from the door.
You should open the door with the 10-foot pole.
All you hear is the beating of your own heart.
Boom, 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 boom. Oh god, the door's
well,
breathing.
Tomb of Horrors is any indication, we probably won't be hearing that for long.
Yeah.
Wow, the floor is different.
I should probably put my character sheet somewhere where it doesn't block the screen every time I look at it.
I can't even see the floor. It's a bunch of question marks. Am I in a
Man, what is wrong
later?
With your computer?
On the plus side, it means that you can see where everything should be. Right, so are any of you actually going to enter the next room?
No.
I'll hide behind the thieves.
Silently. Up
there. Yeah, I'll check the floor for
Yeah, I'll just stand right
50.
Behind.
50, pass. Don't step inside without waiting for me to check. Or, well, hey, go ahead, it's your funeral.
He's going to die. He's going to die.
Yeah, I'm going to search... While you search the floor, I'm going to search the walls if it's okay. If it's safe with... After Bobbin says yes or no.
Hey, if he dies, I totally call it dibs on his stuff.
I think we have video game lives. This is how we're supposed to do it. That's how we're doing it.
No one has died yet.
Yet is the key word,
including
there.
The person in the next room.
Really? Okay, I follow his exact path into the room.
Yeah, I'm going to stand on the exact same square. We're hugging now. We're spooning on the All right. square.
All right, I'll check the rest of the floor for traps.
Yeah, very gay, guys.
I'd rather be gay than dead.
And if there's no... If there's no traps on the floor, I rolled a 6 for searching for traps on the walls.
Alright, you don't see traps on the walls, but you do see a large variety of frescoes.
What?
What's a fresco?
That's a fresco.
It is a fresco.
The kind of pastry?
I know what a fresca is.
Think like the sort of illustrations on a pyramid wall.
Is it magical
writing?
Okay,
what do they look like?
Are they traps?
But, yeah, the stone has been coated in plaster and then painted over with various images of human and semi-human and demi-human
things. Oh god, it's rape.
Things.
It's telling us what's gonna happen.
Doing awful, murderous, horrible things to each other.
Oh my god, you're
looking guys, hold up.
Is this
hold
an up. Orgy?
No, guys. I'm starting to think the Tomb of Horrors might not just be a name.
Yeah, it's a name. It's a very accurate name, but it is a name. You still haven't told us if there's traps on the floor.
So, the Tomb of Horrors is an SMN fetish club.
Is
sounds
something
about right.
There
it's
the
safe
us?
Word.
Well, there's S&M, there's cannibalism.
Yummy.
There's being sacrificed to horrible evil gods. Basically, every sort of terrible thing that you can imagine in two dimensions is on these walls.
Don't look at them too much, it might take wisdom damage.
Wait, two dimensions? But I already take it three dimensions and see in 3D.
Yeah, but they're on the walls. So
yeah,
unless the wall
I cast Fireball at Akbar.
You will all get hit by the backlash. Just saying.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
I still think it's worth it.
Where'd the door go?
Who dissolved my door?
Sorry. Right, yeah, but seriously, me. Searching for traps.
Not me.
I'm going to search for any hidden doors.
Yep, I'll do that too.
Yeah,
I roll
same.
A 2.
I rolled a 1.
Alright, yeah, search for traps and hidden doors.
Well, congratulations, you've discovered that one rather jackal-like creature is holding what appears to be a ball in his hand.
I put my penis in it.
on closer inspection, the ball can actually be pulled out of the wall and turned.
Alright, everyone step away from the walls.
I'm gonna check it for traps!
Wait...
And at that moment, the jackal-like creature decides to get out and attack.
Oh boy.
What?
Oh,
no!
Boy.
Oh, hey.
So does his friend.
Hey. Oh god.
Oh.
Oh.
Alright, everyone roll initiative, right?
No. No. First, roll surprise.
Okay.
Wait,
how do we do that?
How do we do that?
How do you do that?
You roll a d6. If it's 1 or 2, then you're surprised. Except for the ranger. Because the ranger is only surprised on a roll of 1.
Really?
Well, I got a 5.
Really?
I got a 3.
I got a 3.
I got a
3.
Or I got a 6. Oh, excellent. I got a 6.
Wait. How do you roll a d6 now?
Slash roll d6.
Oh, okay. I got 6.
Well, there you go. No one is terribly surprised when the paintings come alive to attack.
When the paintings come alive to try and kill you, no one is alarmed at all.
It's just a standard day.
Alright, and here's how initiative works in first edition. I roll a d6 for you guys, and then a d6 for the monsters.
Oh god, he's gonna kill us already.
You rolled a 6, so all of you go first.
Sweet! All right.
Hang on, if I use my wand of lightning on the upper jackal, would it hit those two?
Wait, guys, hold on. Hey, guys, I gotta go now, so yeah.
Alright, see ya.
Alright,
see ya.
See ya.
Just delete your POG before you go.
So yeah, I was thinking about using a wand of lightning as well.
Yeah, who?
Delete your POG before you go, so I know who's missing. Yeah, just drag it off into the library. It'll disappear.
See it.
See it.
See it.
Alright, so who's a what? Who's the frost giant? Like, what's his class?
I'm using the frost giant for Kalon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, wand of lightning.
Alright, yeah.
That was my plan, too.
Okay, yeah.
So how do you do that?
Would I hit anyone if I used it on the upper one?
You would hit the people between you and him, yes.
Okay.
It's 10 feet, it's a 10 foot wide, or even just...
Well, what if I narrowed it?
You would still hit them, it's...
10 feet wide.
Okay.
You wouldn't have to move out of the way, and then...
Yeah, you would have to move towards the things.
Okay.
The jackal weirs.
Actually, wait, ooh. Oh, wait, no, it's only 7 HP.
Hang on, if I use sleep, could I hit them without hitting us? Are they even, like, things that could fall asleep?
Hang on, let me just...
Gnolls, I think they are things that could fall asleep.
Actually, yes.
They can fall asleep?
Potentially hit them with sleep.
Alright, and without hitting us?
Sleep is one of the spells where you pick your targets.
Alright, then I'll cast sleep.
Alright. Now that has a time in terms of segments.
One. It says 1S.
Huh. That's right.
Yep.
Well, I'll just say it goes off straight away then.
Alright. I'm going to use...
I do need to roll a die to see how many you can affect.
So okay. Since I was checking one of the gnolls, I'm right next to him, right?
Yeah, you're adjacent to them.
I'm gonna take... Well, doesn't matter if I get a... If I cast right next to him or not. Is there attacks of opportunity in this?
You are only able to affect one of the jackal weirs.
Which
well,
one?
That's... I mean, I didn't mind... I don't mind that.
I think he was
just...
talking about my sleep spell. Okay, yeah, it's asleep. It's the one next to you is asleep, so the other one's there.
Oh, the one next to me is asleep?
Yep.
Yes.
I'm gonna use... Can I use my wand of lightning on the other one? Without hitting anybody?
No, you did as
yeah,
well.
you've got a clear line of sight.
How do I... Oh, that's 3 segments. So...
How long is that? How many segments are in a turn?
One turn is 10 rounds. So, one round is 10 segments, so... You can... Yeah.
I could do that.
It'll take 36 seconds to fire off.
Oh, wow. That long?
Wow.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
A melee round is 1 minute.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna shoot my lightning at him.
Alright.
I want a lightning. How does that work?
Well, you've declared it.
Yeah.
And now everybody else who hasn't done anything tells me what they're doing.
I'm gonna cast
and
magic.
And after you do that...
Which one are you lightning bowling?
The one that isn't asleep.
Then you're gonna hit Kalon and Thandamel.
That's the north wall. Well, no, I'm assuming he can at least aim sideways far enough that he'll only hit the jackal weir.
If not, I can always have it doing a 5 foot wide.
He's I suck at names, so he's kind of right behind the two people.
No, that's me.
Oh, that's you?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay, yeah. Alright.
He's the NPC, I guess.
Okay, I see. That's better.
That makes sense. Okay.
Right, so one of you casts sleep, one of you is using a wand of lightning. Do the other two of you want to do anything?
Yeah, I'm gonna cast.
And keep in mind that one of your options is go over to the sleeping jackal weir and kill it.
Do that.
It is specifically listed in the sleep spell's description that sleeping creatures can be just killed.
Alright, then I'm gonna cast magic missile at the jackal weir. The one that isn't asleep.
Alright, that's fair.
And then I'll cast it again at the, I'll cast one of them at the one that is asleep. Five to the one that isn't.
Wait, wouldn't that wake it up?
Well, no,
I think that would wake it up.
Don't waste the damage, just throw it all at the waking one, that way the one that's awake will just be instantly killed.
Yeah, I'll just go and kill the one that's sleeping.
Alright, so 1d4 plus 1. So I do 3 damage on the first bolt.
You know, you can actually just roll that as collectively. Just slash, roll.
5d4.
Oh, wow!
5d4 plus 5. Oh. That's something that the game table can let you do.
You can also just set up a macro and hit a button.
Alright, right. So I rolled 24.
My wand of lightning did 14 damage.
Well, that was weird.
21 both times.
I got 2 6 and 4 ones.
Alright, so are they dead?
They've only got 4 hit points.
No,
no, sorry. Hit dice. They have 4 hit dice.
Oh, 4 hit dice, okay.
Slightly better.
Oh my god. I mean, I knew it wasn't combat heavy, but Jesus, 4 hit points?
We're dead!
I have done a few modifications to the dungeon.
They are dead though, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh. Okay. Did where they walked out of the wall reveal anything?
Yeah, that was sort of my contribution. You see, just a quick combat tutorial for you.
All 4 hit points of it.
All right. I checked the door for traps.
That's great.
Well, you already checked the walls for traps. And didn't
No, I meant the secret door.
So they were holding like orbs things, right?
Right, and the orb turned out to be a knob, and the knob opened the a passageway that sort of curves out and to the left.
Okay.
Hey, Kalon, you go first.
Floor for traps. Yeah, I was gonna search the floor for traps. 47.
None that you can find.
All right. Cool.
Floor's fine.
And it ends in a dead end.
Everyone search for
Search for secret doors.
Yeah, I'm gonna search for secret doors.
2.
Ditto.
2.
Alright, that's enough.
Everyone piles in, then the old door closes and it fills with water.
Oh, I know. I have a spell for that.
You see beyond the door a long corridor.
Is that blood?
Nobody walk in there. What's that line?
It's got more frescoes on the walls, and the floor is a mosaic of stones.
What's that red line?
In particular, starting at the door you just opened, is a red line of mosaic that sort of forms a pattern, a path along the mosaic.
Okay, hang on. Can I push past one of these guys?
Yes.
Alright. I'm not going to step on the floor yet, but I pod the floor on the path with the 10-foot pole and then off the path with the 10-foot pole.
I will admit, I have lived longer than I was expecting to.
You said prod the path, don't move it. Alright, got my own dice out here. Alright, neither reveals any sort of pit traps.
Oh, okay. That doesn't help much, but I'll search for traps anyways, just to be safe.
Yeah.
15.